Good day, everyone. Today we will be looking at analytical geometry for grade 12, and today's lesson will be lesson 1. Firstly, we start off with things that we should know, things that should be in our toolbox at this point in time, and our prior knowledge will consist of a few items that we need to know. If we don't have this, then we won't have much success with this. So, first of all, ordered number piece consists out of an x and a corresponding y value. Distance formula, you should be very familiar with Pythagoras. Midpoint formula, the gradient. Now, there's four different types of gradients that we can get. Firstly, if they give me the two coordinates, I can calculate the gradient in the following way. If I know it is parallel lines, I know that gradient 1 is equal to gradient 2. If they are perpendicular lines, I know that the gradient of line 1 multiply with the gradient of line 2 will give me a result of negative 1. And the fourth way is if they gave me the angle of inclination. Remember angle of inclination? The angle that the line makes with the x-axis, always in a positive growth. Right? Then I can calculate, once I've got the gradient and I've got the coordinate, then I can calculate the equation of a straight line. Now there's three different ways. Most of you will be familiar with y is equal to mx plus c, or the function formula ax plus q, or y minus y1 is equal to the gradient into x minus x1. Then we get to the equation of a circle. We should be familiar with this, but if not, we will just touch on it quickly. X squared plus y squared is equal to r squared, and this particular one is where the origin is the center of the circle. Last but not least, we must also be familiar with completing the square. And for those who can't remember, when we work with an equation, our a value must always be positive. Ax squared plus bx plus c, the a value must always be positive 1. So we add and subtract half of the b value squared. And this is if it's on the same side. If it's on either side of the equal sign, we will add on both sides of the equal sign. As you may have noticed, analytical geometry is concerning my Cartesian plane and calculations on the Cartesian plane. So let's get straight into it. When we look at the circle and the origin is 0 and 0, and we need to calculate the equation of the circle, we need to calculate the gradient of the radius, and we will have to calculate a tangent at a point on the circle. So the first thing we will do is we will use that coordinate to calculate the equation of the circle. So x squared plus y squared is equal to r squared. In this case, my origin is 0 and 0. And only when it's 0 and 0, I may use the following approach. I first calculate r, which is my x value squared, plus my y value squared. So 36 plus 64 gives me 100. R squared is 100. So I do not calculate the value of r. I only need r squared. And in this case, x squared plus y squared is equal to 100. That's my equation of my circle. Now that I have the equation of my circle, I move over to the following. I calculate firstly the gradient of the radius. Why do I need to find the gradient of the radius? If I'm going to construct a line that touches the circle, which we call a tangent, touches the circle at one point, then the radius will be perpendicular to the tangent. So, we first want to calculate the gradient of the radius. So, the gradient of the radius, remember the origin is 0 and 0, and C is 6 and 8. So, we say y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1, or alternatively, y of the origin minus y of a point C on the graph. So that is 0 minus the 8. Then we get 0 minus 8 on top. At the bottom is my x values, so that it must be in the same order. So 0 minus 6. So I find myself with minus 8 over minus 6. Answer, negative divided by negative is positive. So simplified form, it is 4 over 3. Before we continue, I just want to do the following. When we work with circles and lines, there's three things that I need. I can have a circle and a line where there's no contact. I can have a circle and a line where they touch at a point, and generally we will label it as a tangent. So where the circle touch only at one point. Then we get a circle with a line that touches at two points, cuts the circle at two points, and this part here is known as a chord. So we've worked with a circle with a line where they separate, a tangent, and also a chord that is extended or protruded further beyond that point. Now we're going to construct a tangent at that point, so it passes the circle and touches at C. So now I've constructed my tangent. I need to now calculate the gradient of that tangent, and I know that when two lines meet each other at 90 degrees, the one line's gradient will be the reciprocal of the other line's gradient. So let's see quickly. We know that the gradient of my radius is 4 over 3. I know that when I work with perpendicular lines, gradient 1 multiplied with gradient 2 will give me a result of negative 1. So I substitute gradient 1, which is 4 over 3, multiply with gradient 2 equal to negative 1. Now I want to isolate m gradient 2, so I multiply this side by 3 over 4, and I multiply this side also by 3 over 4. So m's gradient 2 is then equal to negative 3 over 4. Now that I have the gradient, I may substitute my gradient with negative 3 over 4. My x value was 6 and my y value was 8. I substituted in this equation and I calculate the value of C. Now that I've calculated the value, this is 18 over 4, negative 18 over 4. I add negative 18 over 4. I add negative 18 over 4 on the left hand side as well. I get a total of 12,5. So the value of C is 12,5. I have not yet written the equation. I must still write the equation of the tangent. So the equation of the tangent is then given by y is equal to negative 3 over 4x plus 12,5. If I have decided to plug it into this equation, the same protocols would have sufficed there. Would have still been my 8 for my y1 value, my x1 value would have been 6, and my gradient that I substituted is negative 3 over 4. Calculate my values and I still get to the same answer. You notice that the equation of the tangent is then given by negative 3 over 4x plus 12,5. Let's now try to practice what we've learned in the session by doing the following. Calculate the equation of a circle with origin as the center passing through the following three points. First equation of the center. Then we're going to calculate the gradient of the radius. That will be AO, the gradient. Then we will calculate the gradient of OB, and we will calculate the gradient of OC. Now that you have the gradients, then at 3 you will calculate the gradient of the tangent that passes through point 15 and 8. The tangent that passes through 5 and 11, and the tangent that will pass through 9 and minus 4. To conclude today's lesson, the homework will be the following three exercises. Tangent passing through B, 3 and 4. Tangent passing through 4 and negative 3. The tangent passing through 3 and negative 4.